In this short presentation, I try to give you an overview about the therapeutic research system. We will go through investigation in order to prove that it is an excellent approach to improve logotherapy presentation in the academic world. At the same time, it is an interesting way of exchanging points of view with other psychological lines. Besides, these works contribute to the development of logotherapy research, including logotherapy. En esta breve presentación intentaré dar una visión general sobre la investigación logoterapéutica en España. Se presenta la investigación como un camino de diálogo con otros ámbitos y también como un desarrollo de la propia logoterapia. The investigation system has a direct relationship with the goal of doing statistical validity to the logotherapeutic postulates. Jointly, in several works, they have tried in convincing
they are directed researches to confirm and give statistical validity to the logotherapeutic conception on human existential experiences. We have been able to collect the works that have been made around AISLO's activities. People who are associated to AISLO or who have contacted with us looking for guidance, comparing ideas and sharing their results. We have also searched on the official database of Spanish doctoral thesis named TISEO. La investigación en España está directamente relacionada con el objetivo de dar una validez estadística a los postulados logoterapéuticos y bueno, se han podido recopilar trabajos realizados en torno a AISLO y también de la base de datos oficial de España que se llama TISEO. We can refer the following basic research lines. Basic tools and applied studies. Bueno, se presentará dos líneas básicas de investigación, una relacionada con herramientas básicas o test y otra sobre estudios aplicados. Espera, que estoy. ¿Dónde se le da? Aquí. 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 Currently, the first line is aimed to deepen the meaning constant multidimensionality, and the second one to study the relationship between self-concept, use of leisure time, and values in young people as related with meaning in their lives. Es decir, estas dos líneas que se iniciaron actualmente se encuentran en el camino de dar una mayor profundización al constructo multidimensional de sentido y una segunda sobre el autoconcepto, uso de tiempo libre y valores en los jóvenes en relación con el sentido en sus vidas. In Spain, we have available to us five norms of logotherapeutic tests. And we have norms for 1-6 tests, but these norms have not been published yet. Entonces, bueno, aquí se pueden ver los tests logoterapéuticos que ya tenemos baremados en España. All these tests are self-administered where people describe his or her situation through a Likert scale. Todos los tests son de autoinforme donde las personas describen su situación con una escala Likert. In the process of getting norms, we have confirmed that there is no significant difference between men and women. No hay una diferencia significativa entre hombres y mujeres. However, there have been obtained age differences, so we must apply different norms according to age. Sin embargo, sí que se han obtenido diferencias por edad, por lo que tenemos que aplicar baremos diferenciados. It's time to bring two questions regarding to obtain test norms. The first one deals with making a decision between getting norms of existing tests or elaborating new tests. I usually choose getting norms from existing tests. The reason is to be able to compare results from different countries and from different researches. Choosing a new test needs to have a specific and significant improvement goals. The second question is related to need of getting specific norms. These will be applied for each country and for specific socio-cultural groups. We must not use norms of population other than ours. In the slide, we have an example of different total scores obtained in three countries for one test. Bueno, y planteo dos cuestiones sobre las que reflexionamos en relación con los test. Una relativa a si baremar los test ya existentes o hacer otros nuevos, y la otra es la necesidad de siempre aplicar test que están validados en una población. Son las características que vamos a ver. Bueno. These are the graphics of factorial structure of PAL, SOMP R and logo test. No podemos dedicar más tiempo. Existential scale was made with a specific theoretical structure. However, it's not confirmed with the empirical factor obtained in Spain. Only self-distance subscale can be considered matching to one factor. La escala existencial que se construyó con un determinado marco teórico, bueno, pues el comportamiento del test en España no ha confirmado los factores que esa estructuración teórica se correlacione con factores. Solamente uno podía ser, ajustarse un poquito. Bueno. These are the data of reliability of the test. Validity has been analyzed through the correlation between score of the test. And we have also related the test factorial scores. Es decir, también hemos obtenido la validez a través de correlaciones entre las puntuaciones de los test. Y bueno, pues hay bastante varianza compartida, como se puede ver. Y también hemos obtenido las correlaciones entre las puntuaciones factoriales. All the studied tests are related to the same construct, meaning in life. Going deeply into this construct is the main aim of the research that we are currently developing in the Spanish Association of Logotherapy. Entonces, todos los test con los que hemos estado trabajando se refieren al mismo constructo, sentido en la vida, eso nos lo demuestran las correlaciones. Y pretendemos profundizar en el concepto de sentido en la vida pues a través de estos estudios. When we study the answers of the tests, we can reflect on existential themes. For example, analyzing the answer with the score of 4, neutral or blank answers, some interesting results were found. Es decir, que con los tests también podemos reflexionar sobre temas existenciales, no son solo datos. Si vemos las contestaciones a los neutros, se han encontrado algunos datos interesantes. The more difficult items to be answered with the score of 4 were the ones related to death, meaning in life, and the relationship with the world. Both young people and adults found some difficulties with these themes, but they have specific nuances regarding age. Death was common in both groups. Meaning in life for young people is focused on the perception of meaning in daily life. However, adults focus on existential balance. Difficulties in relationships with the world is in facing responsibilities in the youngsters. Instead, for adults, is the perception of meaning. Es decir, los ítems que más costaban contestar eran los relacionados con la muerte, el sentido en la vida y la relación con el mundo. Eran temas comunes tanto en jóvenes como en adultos, pero tenían matices diferentes. Por ejemplo, el sentido en la vida para los jóvenes se centraba en la percepción del sentido de cada día y para los adultos se enfocaba en el balance existencial que hacían de su vida. Now we can briefly consider the applied studies. They can be grouped by theme in drug addiction versus meaning, dealing with disease processes and another life situation. Los estudios aplicados los podemos dividir en los relativos a adicción en contraposición con sentido, afrontar la enfermedad y otras situaciones estresantes en la vida. Several researches have confirmed that groups with drug addiction problems have significant lower scores than normative group. Besides, it has been proved that increase the of meaning when people progress in a therapeutic program. You can see in the slide green, blue and dark blue are growing. Los estudios lo que prueban es la relación entre vacío existencial y drogadicción. Tests have also been used to evaluate and prevent the abandonment in a therapeutic educational program. Tests could be indicators of abandonment. También se han utilizado los tests para evaluar y prevenir abandonos en un programa terapéutico educativo y los tests podían ser predictores de abandonos. These are the themes of applied studies. You can see in the slide they are varied suffering situations. And now I would like to present some brief notes about current research lines in ASLO frameworks. Entonces, bueno, ahora lo que me quería es un poco presentar las líneas actuales de la investigación. La primera, que se refiere al autoconcepto, el uso del tiempo libre, los valores y el sentido en los jóvenes. Y el segundo, sobre el constructo de sentido. The first research, we analyzed data from 345 participants. Half of them were university students and the other were their friends without any relationship with the university. We wanted to control some variables such as being a student or not, being a worker or not, and sex. The logotherapeutic tests used were PAL and some PAL. Bueno, pues este es el diseño de la investigación con jóvenes, que se llevó con 345 jóvenes, unos la mitad estudiantes y la mitad amigos suyos, con esos instrumentos e intentando controlar algunas variables. Bien. The main show of meaning in Jaster is personal relationship with family and friends. The research offered paths to strengthen meaning in youngsters. Entonces vemos las variables más importantes para los jóvenes. Y tú defines. The second line is the meaning construct multidimensionality. We have the same construct in all the tests, but with different matices. We have made many empirical and test analysis, and summarizing the results, we point out the following meaning dimensions. Es decir, hemos localizado dimensiones de sentido diferenciadas: perception of global life meaning, daily experience of meaning, will of meaning, appeal of conscience, orientation to goals, self-transcendence, creative experiential and aptitudinal values, religious commitment, destiny freedom dialectic, freedom responsibility binomial, decision capability and attitude facing death. Es decir, hay muchos factores, todos en relación con el sentido. And this is the final phrase to remember Viktor Frankl. Therefore, we can say that logotherapy gives Stedman back his own self-comprehension to improve the awareness of his essential constitution. Empirical research also contributes to that goal.